go well, we take it for granted. But we thought that this one is worth acknowledging. But perhaps most outstanding, Mr. Senior President, is the way the National Assembly, under your leadership, has passed into law the amendment to the offshore, deep offshore oil quota sharing that promises to increase revenue of Nigeria substantially, and that we are able to resist all the temptations arising from the powers that, you know, have denied this the country the passage of this law, you know, over the years. And I was also excited to see Mr. President, you know, signing into law that act, even in London. I get a couple of implications for this. That, like you, the president recognized that if you can manage it as quickly as you did and come out with such fundamental amendment that has such enormous impact on the national revenue, he, as president, also had to do the needful. And I think by signing into law in London, in Nigeria House in London, he showed that wherever the president is, he's presiding over Nigeria. And with the benefit of modern technology and so on, we are past the Mogopak era. So in signing it in London, for me, has also made several statements, namely that wherever national interest is involved, the president is on duty. Wherever he is, he's presiding. And I also want to salute his acceptance to the bill, you know, as fastly as he did, and even the Nigeria House in London. Now, why is it necessary to speak to this? Mr. Senior President, people always say that virtually every Nigerian of age knows what our problems are. And that is why the most viable industry in Nigeria are seminars, are conferences, are workshops. And in every archive, you find all kinds of recommendations. There is nothing that Nigeria don't know. What is missing is that level of integrity you require to subordinate your personal interest when the forces are unleashed, to subordinate your personal interest and all temptation and submit to the logic of national interest, even if that will lead to personal deprivation. And it is this difference that I believe the National Assembly, under your leadership, across party divide, you know, has brought to bear. And we thought that Nigerians ought to celebrate you. We as a party, we celebrate our APC members. We also celebrate the PDP members, because we monitor the debate. There is no evidence that there's any party divide. National interest was at play. And so we have come to appreciate you, and I do hope that under your leadership, the Senate will be a formidable national pillar that Nigerians can rely on in our journey to take the nation to the next level. Mr. President, thank you so much for granting us this opportunity.